Welcome to the channel. Are you still worried about signal attenuation when the network cable exceeds 100 meters? Today, I will tell you a simple way to easily solve these problems. All we need is this small device, SIP media converter, which can convert electrical signals into optical signals and easily break distance limits of 100 meters through fiber transmission. Traditional home wiring is to use network cables to connect routers and then wire them to various network ports in the home. However, if network cable distance exceeds 100 meters, the signal quality will be significantly reduced. This is mainly because, such as crosstalk, the wires inside the cable mess with each other. Especially long distance crosstalk will be more serious, and EMI, this will make the signal worse. Optical fiber don't have these limitations. They have a fast speed, low latency, and a long transmission distance. Plus, optical fiber are made of glass, so they are also resistant to EMI. However, the interface of optical fiber cable is not RJ45, so they cannot be directly connected to the routers and our network devices. At this time, a media converter is needed to solve this problem. We need two because we need to convert the electrical signal into an optical signal first, and then convert the optical signal into the electrical signal. One goes near your router and the other goes near the device that's far away. We can see that there are two ports on the media converter. One is RJ45 port, it will connect the network cable, and one is SIP port. So we need a pair of SIP modules. The one I have in my hand is BD SIP module. You can see it has a simplex LC port. Compared with the traditional duplex module, the BD module uses different wavelengths for sending and receiving. You can see this one is 1550 nanometer and the other is 1310 nanometer. And the pouring colors are also different. Of course, what kind of module determines what kind of fiber cable to use. So we use simplex cable to connect here. It can save 50% of optical fiber resources compared to choosing a duplex module. Oh, and by the way, the fiber cable we are using has a LC connector. There are others like SC and ST, but I recommend LC because it's easier to find and more common. Okay, let's set this up. First, plug both media converter into power. Then, connect the network cable from your router's LAN port to the media converter's RJ45 port. And insert the SIP module. And then, we insert one end of fiber optic cable. We are using a 10 km cable here to simulate a long-distance connection, but you can pick a length you need. Now, do the same with the other media converter. Insert the SIP module. Connect the other hand of fiber optic cable. Finally, connect the media converter to your computer's internet port with another network cable. You will see the lights on the media converter turn on, showing a gigabit connection. Now, check your PC. It's probably offline right now. Let's refresh it. Okay, now it's connected to the internet. This setup is easy. No complicated settings, just plug and play. But keep in mind, these media converters are just converters. They won't magically turn your 100 megabits into 1 gigabit. Your final speed depends on your internet plan. What the converters do is reduce signal loss and improve network quality by switching between electrical signal to optical signal. Also, using better network cables like CAT6, CAT6A or higher can help you get the most out of the network. For example, CAT5B usually supports 2.5 gigabits and CAT6 or higher support 10 gigabits. The above is all our content. If this video is helpful to you, please like and subscribe to us. You can click on creativitech.com to purchase all the equipment used in this content. Welcome to visit.